So recently, I showed you guys how to solve this cubic equation by using cosine. Yes, cosine. If you want to see that video, it will be on my main channel. Link will be in the description. But of course, we do not have to go there. This is just a regular cubic equation. We can solve this by the rational zero theorem. So have a look here. First off, we are going to pay attention to this equation being equal to zero. Pay attention to the constant term here. We have 48. And then think about all the ways we can break down 48, so the factors of 48. We know 1 times 48 is 48. So 1 is a factor, 48 is also a factor, but most likely we're not going to use 48. But anyways, and then continue. 2 times 24 will also be 48, right? So 2 and 24. And then 3 and 16. And 4 and 12. And then 6 and 8, and then 8 and 6, by which is the same as 6 and 8. So these are it. And then we are going to pay attention to the coefficient of the leading term, which is the x cubed. It's a 1. So just divide everybody by 1, which doesn't really matter. Now, these are the factors. We are going to consider the both positive and also the negative version of them. So plus or minus, plus or minus, plus or minus, all that. And technically, we should also have divided by the 1. But you guys know, divided by 1 doesn't matter. So it's like this. Imagine though, if you have a 5 here, not only you have to divide it by the 1s, you also have to write it down and divide the 5s. But yeah, this is it. So these right here are all the possible rational, meaning you have a fraction in the sense of a whole number divided by whole number, both positive or negative. So possible rational zeros for the equation here. Or sometimes it's also called the root. So depends on how you want to call it. Possible rational zeros. I don't know if it's an S or ES, but anyways. So these are the numbers that we should plug into the equation and check if we end up with zero or not. Yeah, if we don't have anything from here works, then this equation is not solvable with the rational zero theorem. Then you might have to do the cosine formula. But anyways, this is how you can do it. If you plug in 1, just pick the easy number 1, right? So 1 cubed minus 28. And then times 1 plus 48, well, that's negative 27 plus 48. It's not going to be 0, so 1 doesn't work. I'm going to erase that. Next, 48 doesn't really work. And then plus or minus still doesn't really work. Try 2, right? Try the 2 right here. I'm going to plug in 2 in here. So we are looking at 2 cubed minus 28 times 2. And then plus 48, is this going to give us 0? Well, this is 8, and this is minus 56. Together, this is negative 48 plus the 48 is indeed equal to 0. So 2, it's a root. And you can just do this real quick, right? Just kind of plug in numbers and all that. That said, I'm going to just do this for you guys right here. Firstly, I'll just say note that x equals 2 is a 0 or a root. Seriously, same thing. Or root. Rational root. Right. Meaning, if you plug in into the x, you end up with 0. It's a solution to this equation. So what this means is, right here, you can factor this cubic equation with x minus 2. So have a look. I'm going to write down x minus 2, and then times another factor, and hopefully we'll be able to figure this out, and then we can factor it. And to factor this, we can use the so-called synthetic division, or if you would like, you can also do the polynomial long division. But if you just have x minus the number or x plus the number, synthetic division is going to be easier. And this is how it works. So have a look. I'll show you guys this right here. Write down the coefficients from the equation. starting with 1, x cubed, so it's 1. But next, we don't have any x squared term, right? So make sure you write down a 0. It's like a placeholder. You have to write down the 0. Continue with the negative 28. Lastly, we have the positive 48. Then, we are going to set it up because x is equal to 2. You put a little 2 right here. Right? This is a setup. Now, this is the first step. Bring down the 1. And to continue, what you do is you take the 2 times the 1 and then put it here, which is a 2. Now, have a look. 0 plus 2 is 2. And then just continue. 2 times 2, which is 4, put it here. And then once again, you work that out. For synthetic division, we are adding them. So negative 28 plus 4 is negative 24. One more time, we have negative 48. When we add, we get 0. If x equals 2 is indeed a solution, then the remainder here must be 0. This final number must be 0. So this right here, right, it's going to give us a quadratic factor because originally we have x cubed and we divide it by x to the first power. So the power goes down by 1. Therefore, it's a quadratic. And the coefficient of the factor are here. 1x squared, 2x, and then minus 24 without the x. And then remainder is 0. So I'm just going to put down x squared, positive 2x, so that's plus 2x. And then lastly, we have the minus 24, just like that. Now, to factor a quadratic, of course, we can just do it regularly. So I will do it regularly. This is x minus 2. Because it's just x squared, so I'm just going to open two sets of the parentheses here. Like this and like that. X times x gives us the x squared. Then we have to think about two numbers. They multiply to negative 24. Together, they add up to positive 2. What are the choices? 6 and 4. Which one's negative? Negative 4, yes, good. So plus 6 and then minus 4. And that's equal to 0. Now, we just factored this cubic equation into a product of three linear factors. So this means put the first factor equal to 0, put the second factor equal to 0, and then the third factor equal to 0. Sorry. Therefore, we get x, just add the 2 to both sides, x equals 2 for the first answer, and then subtract 6 to both sides, and then add 4 to both sides. And ladies and gentlemen, very nice, huh? That's it.